Shabbat shalom. See, I will send the prophet Elijah to you before that great and dreadful day of the Lord comes. This is what the Bible says in Malachi 4, verse 5. The last verse of the Old Testament. A very important verse because these were the last words from God to the people of Israel. His last words, a promise. A promise to send an end-time messenger, Elijah. Making all of us clear who the real Father is. So who is this Elijah? There are many great prophets in the Old Testament, but one is considered the greatest, Elijah. The name Elijah means Yahweh is God. Elijah does just as his name, encourage the people to believe that truly the Lord is God. The Bible tells us that Elijah was a man like the rest of us. He struggled with the same passions and doubts that we have. Elijah was a man of prayer and did many miracles in cooperation with God. And suddenly, he ran for his life because of a woman, Jezebel. She cursed him. This sounds familiar, right? One moment we are full of faith and 1 minute later we are on the run. Elijah's name in Hebrew has 5 letters. Aleph, Lamed, Yod, He, and Vav. But wait a minute. In Malachi 4, verse 5, the name Elijah has only 4 letters. The last letter, Vav, is missing. The Bible makes no mistakes, so there must be a reason. The name Elijah appears 71 times in the Old Testament, and 5 times Elijah's name is spelled without the Vav at the end. So where did these 5 letters go? Interestingly, these 5 letters have been transferred to the name of another person in the Bible. Jacob, Israel. Jacob's name in Hebrew has 4 letters, Yod, Ayin, Kuf, and Bet. But 5 times in the Old Testament, Jacob's name is spelled with 5 letters, including a Vav. Yod, Ayin, Kuf, Vav, and Bet. In other words, 5 times in scripture, the letter Vav is missing from Elijah's name, and 5 times it is added to Jacob's name. It's obvious that there is something Elijah has that Jacob doesn't. This transferal occurs exactly 5 times, which is the numerical value of the Hebrew letter He, which represents the Holy Spirit or the breath of God. That's interesting. God will breathe His Spirit, the same Spirit that empowered Elijah, upon Jacob, Israel, in the last days. I will give them an undivided heart and put a new spirit in them. I will remove from them their heart of stone and give them a heart of flesh. Some people say that Elijah is John the Baptist because Jesus confirms. Some people say it's not true because John confirmed that he was not. The fact is that there are some amazing similarities between the both of them. To mention a few, they were both prophets. Both had a great influence over Israel. Both thought to be killed by kings. Both incurred enmity of a queen. They wore the same kind of garment. And they are both forerunners of the Messiah. Anyway, it's puzzling, but I believe that it's possible that John the Baptist is Elijah. If the Israelites accepted Jesus as the Messiah, then John would have been the end time Elijah. There would not have been a need for Elijah to come again. However, they rejected Jesus and therefore didn't recognize John as Elijah. Jesus says in the Bible, "But I tell you that Elijah has already come," and they did not recognize him, but did to him whatever they pleased. So also the Son of Man will certainly suffer at their hands. And then the disciples understood that he was speaking to them of John the Baptist. Therefore, as John the Baptist announced Jesus' first coming, Elijah will announce Jesus' second coming. The successor of Elijah, his assistant, was Elisha. And Elisha, whose name meant God is salvation, was called to follow Elijah. Elijah prepared the way for Elisha. The Bible says that they both traveled from Gilgal to Bethel, from Bethel to Jericho, and from Jericho to Jordan. This before Elijah ascended to heaven. There's nothing without a reason in the Bible, so why did they travel this route? Gilgal, Bethel, Jericho, and Jordan. Gilgal means rolling or turn away. They rolled away their old life, so to speak. Separation. Bethel means house of God. Beth is house and El is God. Jericho stands for walk of faith. And Jordan stands for resurrection. In other words, the route represents our walk with God. We first walk away from our old life, separation, and we conquer flesh. And then we seek the house, the presence of God. We conquer the world. We walk by faith, we conquer Satan, and we receive eternal life, we conquer death. Beautiful. Elijah did 8 miracles, and just before Elijah leaves the world, Elisha asked Elijah for a double portion of his spirit. Interestingly, the Bible talks about the firstborn receiving a double portion. And who is called God's firstborn in the Bible? Jesus. Elijah replied, "You have asked me a difficult thing, but if you see me when I'm taking from you, it will be yours. Otherwise, it will not." Elijah didn't die, but ascended to heaven, and Elisha witnessed. Today, Elijah is still alive, so he can return to earth before the second coming of Jesus. Jewish people are longing for this moment, the moment that Elijah returns, during Passover. During Passover, they leave one chair empty for Elijah and prepare a plate and fill a special Elijah cup with wine. They even open the entrance door of their houses and ask the children to check in the street. The pagan version is Santa Claus, where parents ask their children to look out for Santa. Now the question is, did Elisha receive the double portion? Elijah did 8 miracles, remember? And how many miracles did Elisha during his life? 15. It doesn't sound like a double portion. Elisha did 15 miracles during his life. But one more miracle happened after his death. After his death, someone threw a body in Elisha's tomb. And when the body touched the bones of Elisha, the man was revived, resurrected. But wait a minute, that sounds like the resurrection of Jesus. Resurrection from the death for someone else. Elisha's death brought life. Could it be that Elisha foreshadowed Jesus, the same way as John the Baptist foreshadowed Elijah? Could it be that Elisha is a prototype of Jesus? When Elijah ascended to heaven, Elisha cried out, my father, the chariots of Israel and its horsemen." In a way, it sounds like, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When Elijah went to heaven, Elisha took hold of his clothes and torn them in 2 pieces. And behold, the veil of the temple was torn from the top to the bottom, the earth shook and the rocks were split. Jesus turned water into wine. Elisha purified the water of Jericho. Elisha takes up the mantle of Elijah at the River Jordan and starts ministry. Jesus is baptized by John at the River Jordan and starts his ministry. Elisha raises the son of the Shunammite woman from the dead. Jesus raises the son of the widow of Nain from the dead. Elisha feeds a group with a few loaves, and there's food left over. And Jesus feeds a group with a few loaves, fishes, and there's food left over. Elisha heals Naaman, the Syrian commander of leprosy. And Jesus heals many lepers. Their names have the same meaning. They are both betrayed for money. Their death bring new life. Anyway, Elijah did 8 miracles and Elisha received a double portion, 16 miracles. He received this double portion because he witnessed Elijah's ascension. Witnessed? Wait a minute. Doesn't the Bible tell us that God will use 2 witnesses in the end times? Two witnesses with miraculous powers to accompany their message? Nowhere does the Bible identify these two witnesses by name. So who are they? There are many speculations on the identity of the two witnesses in Revelation. So let's take a look into the possible candidates. In my opinion, there are only three candidates: Enoch, Elijah, and Moses. Enoch and Elijah seem the most logical because they both didn't die, but they ascended to heaven. Moses died, so not really an option. But let's take a good look at Scripture. Jesus says in Scripture to his disciples, "There are some standing here who will not taste death until they see the kingdom of God." This was fulfilled at the mountain of Transfiguration. What happened over there? Jesus took Peter, James, and John, led them up to the Mount Tabor, and Jesus transfigured before them. There, Elijah appeared to them, along with Moses, and they talked with Jesus. The appearance of his face changed, and his clothes became dazzling white. But wait a minute, dazzling white clothes? Where did we read this before in Scripture? During Jesus' resurrection, two men stood by them in shining garments. During Jesus, his ascension as well. As he went up, two men stood by them in white apparel. People assume that these were two angels, but could it be that these were Elijah and Moses? The Bible talks about both angels and men. Translated from the Greek word agolos, which is translated as messenger, either human or heavenly, could it be that they were witnesses at Jesus' resurrection and ascension? Could it be that the transfiguration was a last-minute briefing? Can it be that there will be the two witnesses in the end times as well? One last question. Why did Michael the archangel dispute with Satan about the body of Moses? Because Moses needed resurrection? Why was Satan interested? Why was he interested in the dead body of Moses? Maybe because Moses was already resurrected? Anyway, let's conclude that I don't know, but it's interesting. To avoid any misunderstandings, I conclude nothing. I only suppose to wake people up, to inspire them, to read and to study this amazing, wonderful book. Anyway, Elijah, what an inspiring figure. In a way, we can conclude that Elijah appears three times. The first in the time with Elisha, second as John the Baptist, and third time during the end time. So what can we learn from all this today? Elijah was like us, like any human. He struggled with his own frailties, but he was still used mightily by God as a servant until Elisha came. Did you know that God did not speak to Elisha in the Bible? God spoke to Elijah, but not to Elisha. Is there any time in the Bible that God speaks to Jesus? No. Why not? Because they are one. They are one. I believe that Elijah was the servant and Elisha was the son. I believe that we carry what Elisha carried. We can do miracles. We can transform lives because of whom we are in him. Have a blessed week. Shabbat Shalom.